Hello everyone, I hope everyone who's watching this here video is having a great day. Welcome back to my channel. Today's set is a Halloween aquarium set. I saw this on Insta from a lady called Dash Nails or something like that. I hope I have that right. So excuse the noise outside if you can hear it. We haven't had electricity for a whole 2 days. And that's why I'm even late with posting. We don't know why. No explanation. We never get an explanation. Anyway, let's walk through this video to see what I did over here. I started off by making 5 strips of gel for the base of the nail, the tank, the base, the nail, yeah. I measured the nail, of course, but I made it a bit longer so that I could have space for laying down when filling in the tank, you know, and stuffing it in with those things, you know. If you don't know what I'm talking about or you don't understand, stay tuned, you'll see what I mean. Then I added some background glitter sequins stuff. I don't know what are those things called, but I put them on the gel, on the tank thingy, so that it has a background reflect sort of thing. Kind of thing, you know. And then I cured it, and then I made 10 roundish stoppers, and one is for the top and one is for the bottom. If this is confusing and you don't understand, which I know you guys absolutely get, I mean, you guys know what I'm talking about. If you don't know, just keep watching it, it'll all make sense. By the way, this is my second aquarium that I'm doing in my life and on this channel. So I was so proud of the first one that in there I mentioned that I'm going to be doing a lot more. Okay, I cleaned up everything, making sure that nothing is tacky, so that, you know, when I put the stuffing in, then nothing gets stuck onto it. So be clear on that and make sure that when you do that, you get that out of the way, then the things will start moving nicely and freely and easily inside. Okay. What else? Oh, so I'm applying the gel on the round-ish lid that goes onto the bottom part of the tank, and I'm loosely applying the gel deliberately so that I can smudge it against the nail, the actual nail. That way it will have that contact. And then I cured it. You get it. I know you get it. Smart people. But I don't just leave it like that. You know, I go back in after curing it. And then I make sure everything is sealed by adding more gel. Even if it's thick, but it's not thick underneath. You know, the part that goes onto my nail. It's more thick on to the tank side than to the nail side. I know you guys get it. That way I know everything is sealed. Okay, it is time to attach the base or the bottom of the tank. So over here, right, I put gel on the bottom part of the nail so that I don't want to get inside the tank and get it smudged or filled with gel on the inside, and then it ends up taking space for the thingies to move around freely. What are these stuff called, guys? Is it glitter? But it's not glitter, it's not shiny. They are those that are just like paper and whatever. What do I call them? And I keep calling them thingies, stuffy thingies. Well, for now I'm gonna call them that, but you will know what I mean or what I'm talking about until I am able to get the proper name. Embellishment? Okay, whatever they are, eh? So that they have enough space to move inside, I just only apply the sides of the nail, and then I attach the tank, and then I go in on the sides after curing, and then I go in on the sides with the clear gel again to seal the sides. That way I don't smudge and stuff the inside with like a whole lot of gel, and then it takes up space again. I know you get what I mean. Let's keep watching. it's shaping this baby up. Shaping it was a breeze. I was worried that the gel that I was using for the first time was gonna be either too soft and then it just, you know, whatever, or it would be too thick and, you know, whatever, and then maybe it will just break or crack. I was just all kinds of worried. I was just overthinking. Obviously it worked out well. But anyway, it's obviously not painful filing the bottom part of the tank, the part, the lid part, which is close to my nail, so don't worry about that. It didn't hurt, it doesn't hurt, and obviously you mustn't stay on one spot for too long. But the thing that I learned and told myself never to repeat again on my first set was that the sides better be snatched. Because if you go back to look at that video, and remember, that was my first time, so don't be hard on me. I didn't like the way the sides were all kinds of wonky, you know? But it was a good and beautiful set. I loved it. I loved it so much so. I told myself, I'm going to be doing a whole lot more of these if this is such a breeze and it looks this beautiful. So here I'm taking care to make sure that I make and keep these nails straight. They better just look beautiful. Anyway, so do you know what happened? It happened in the future of the video is while I'm filing, I realized that dust is getting inside the tank as I'm filing. So I stuffed it with stuff. Well, I cut up a nail wipe. And then I stuff them inside to prevent the other nails from getting dust inside. But I don't think too much dust went into this one. But, you know, to prevent the other nails from getting the other dust, I had to do that. And what else am I missing out here? No, I'm not missing out anything. Keep watching. And don't worry, I'm not gonna keep the video on this speed on all the nails. I only kept it like this for this nail, and then I sped up the other nails. Don't worry about it. Keep watching. Thank you. suddenly the nail is filled with baby oil and it's sealed. I don't know what happened to that clip. I'm shocked. I'm surprised. I don't know what happened. Houdini. But you'll catch the next few nails and you'll see what I did with the first one. And also, I don't know what happened with the pinkies stuffiness stuff. They weren't moving as freely. Yes, they were moving, but they were not moving really. But okay, the others were moving. Okay, then the first two nails were filled and stuffed and they didn't leak any baby oil. Eh? Didn't leak baby oil? Didn't leak baby oil? That doesn't sound right. Didn't leak oil. Like car oil. Like cooking oil. Baby oil leak? Baby oil leak. That's new for me. Okay. I just stuffed everything. Keep watching. And these damn, what are these, caviar beads were giving me a run around, and I was running around like a lot. So that's why I said I had to speed these things up, because that's also another thing that took up too much of my time. Chasing around balls. Wait, what? Forget it. Keep watching.
Thank you.
So this time round, the second nail decided to lick on me. It just decided, hey, wait, I want attention from you. And obviously, I fixed it, gave it the attention it wanted. So in total, I think I had like 30 or so, 30 or more, give or take, leaks on this video, on this set of nails. Okay? But you know, all the leaks that happened, I kept them all in this video. I didn't cut anything out, I didn't leave anything out, just to show you that it does happen. From time to time, it does happen. In this set though, I think if my memory serves me well, I had more leaks on this video, on this set, than in my first set. But let's see what the outcome is like. Keep watching. Snatch
those babies up.
They gotta look fire like, right? I mean,
they gotta look fire.
I'm not obsessing. Maybe I am obsessed, but I'm a perfectionist. Damn it, that's my weakness. It just slows the whole process down.
And a curse all at the same time.
Okay, then I put top coat. I know my top coat. It is beautiful. Oh, look at that.
Wait, that went too fast.
Anyway, you'll get a better view and picture of others. I am so proud of these. And I love how clear they came out. So beautiful. The noise again. Do not wonder. So what's happening right here is I'm trying to show you and me the difference with and without top coat. It's so beautiful and clear thanks to the base what builder gel that I just bought. I thought it would be helpful. Keep watching. Obviously, we gotta cover up the uglies. I use Bling Girls Luminous Orange Gel. I glow in the dark. I applied 3 coats just to get the proper coverage because it's so sheer and see-through. And then I did the sides too, and that too I did like 2 or 3 coats. It's just lines on the side, don't worry. I didn't put you through all 3 coats, just here and there, just to show you how I did it here and there. You are a lot smart. I know I don't need to put you through all that.
pretty beautiful. But then as I was editing, I'm like, where does it start and where does it end? But anyway, maybe I'm just being hard on myself. Again, there we go. But what do you guys think? Do you think the line? I think I shouldn't have. But anyway, they came out so beautiful. My heart was smiling. Look at this, guys. Did you notice as I was doing all these nails how much those things were moving inside? I love, 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 love these nails. And my baby seems to love them too. What do you guys think? Have you done these? Have you done aquarium nails? And if you have, can you tag me? You know, a person can learn a thing or three. By the way, did I mention that they glow in the dark? They do. Guys, thanks for watching. If you are still watching this far, I hope you have yourselves a great day or night further. And I thank you and I appreciate each and every one of you watching, subscribing, unsubscribed, all of you. I thank you all. I thank you all and I pray that you have a blessed day ahead. Thank you very much. Goodbye. Take care.